No less than two of the framers of the 1987 Philippine Constitution are questioning the constitutionality of the Anti-Terrorism Act before the Supreme Court. Christian Monsod and Felicitas Arroyo joined law professors from the Ateneo and Xavier Universities, lawyers from the Ateneo Human Rights Center, and the group Centro to oppose the newly signed measure. According to the group, the broad definition of terrorism under the law could cover legal activities protected under the right to free speech, expression, and assembly. The group says that what the law actually punishes is mere intention to commit a crime, even without overt acts, which is not what criminal laws. The group also asserts that some functions of the Anti-Terrorism Council violate the right to due process. The council, composed of executive officials, can designate persons as terrorists, authorize their arrest without a warrant, detention for up to 24 hours, and the immediate freezing of their assets. Seven framers of the Constitution earlier condemned the Anti-Terrorism Act, saying there are sufficient laws to thwart terrorists. They add, the country has a weakened system of checks and balances, and the public office has been used to settle personal scores. But the president and his allies insist there's nothing to fear.
For the law-abiding citizen of this country, I am addressing you with all sincerity. Huwag ho kayong matakot kung hindi ka terorista. Pero once you blow up simbahan, blow up mo yung marketplace, sino mag... So the right to defend itself accrues to the government heavily.
Yung written authorization na binigay ng ETC doon sa police or sa military, hindi po yan warrant of arrest. Hindi po yan warrant of arrest.
For Senator Panfilo Lacson, the United Nations Secretary General himself had warned terrorists might exploit the pandemic to strike, justifying the urgency of the new measure. He adds, the Philippines surely would not want to be a haven for terrorists in Asia. Another petition filed by Duterte's former Office of the Government Corporate Council Chief Philip Jurado is assailing the alleged railroading of the passage of the law in the House of Representatives.
Basically, we are questioning the constitutionality of the anti-terrorism law, particularly the procedure.
Six petitions against the newly signed law are now in the hands of Supreme Court magistrates. Sources tell ABS-CBN News at least 10 more groups are expected to contest the measure before the High Court. Mike Navalio, ABS-CBN News.